Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome to Pikeville High School's 2019 Veterans Day Salute to Our Nation's Veterans video. To those of us who enjoy the freedoms of this country, Veterans Day may just be another day on the calendar, but we must realize that the freedom we enjoy comes at a tremendous cost. The Veterans Affairs says the purpose of Veterans Day is a celebration to honor America's veterans for their patriotism, love of country, and willingness to serve and sacrifice for the common good. Its roots are in a day known as the end of war to end all wars. During World War I, fighting between Allied nations and Germany ceased when they agreed to an armistice in the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month in 1918. A full 7 months before the Great War officially ended with the signing of the Treaty of Versailles on June 28, 1919 in France. President Woodrow Wilson commemorated the day as Armistice Day later that same year on November 11th, according to the Department of Veteran Affairs. The idea was to make it a day to celebrate heroism with special observances taking place at 11 a.m. In 1914, Armistice Day changed from chiefly honoring veterans of World War I to include those who served in World War II and the Korean War. The 83rd Congress replaced the word armistice with veterans, making November 11th a day to honor all American veterans. In October of that year, the first Veterans Day proclamation was given by President Dwight D. Eisenhower that stated it was in order to ensure proper and widespread observance of this anniversary. All veterans organizations, and the entire citizenry will wish to join hands in the common purpose. We at Pikeville High School honor all veterans for their dedication and sacrifice for the freedom we enjoy.
Arlington National Cemetery is a United States military burial ground in Arlington County, Virginia, across the Potomac River from Washington, D.C.
Before being known as the Arlington Cemetery, this location was the home of Robert E. Lee. The fight over Robert E. Lee's beloved home, seized by the U.S. government during the Civil War, went on for decades. One afternoon in May 1861, a young Union Army officer went rushing into the mansion and commanded the hills across the Potomac River from Washington, D.C. become the cemetery for our country's beloved veterans.
Since the 1860s, it has become the burial ground for over 400,000 of our nation's and 11 other countries' veterans. More than 3 million people visit the cemetery annually.
Now let us take a moment to honor some of our veterans who lay rest in the Arlington Cemetery.
Thank you. gun salute is the most commonly recognized of the customary gun salutes that are performed by the firing of cannons or artillery as a military honor. The custom stems from naval tradition where a warship would fire its cannons harmlessly out to sea until all ammunition was spent to show that it was disarmed, signifying the lack of hostile intent. As naval customs evolved, 21 guns came to be fired for heads of state or, in exceptional circumstances, for head of government, with the number decreasing with the rank of the recipient of the honor. While the 21-gun salute is the most commonly recognized, the number of rounds fired in any given salute will vary depending on the conditions. Circumstances affecting these variations include the particular occasion and, in the case of military and state funerals, the branch of service, the rank, or office of the person to whom honors are being rendered.
Zachary, and today we are interviewing my grandfather, Charles Coakley. He served in the Army during the Vietnam War, and he was a sergeant. He served in Pleiku, Vietnam.
A little bit of each. I was drafted to begin with on October 6, 1967, and because I wasn't offered the courses that I wanted to take, I re-upped for another year, so it ended up that I was considered a regular Army and not a draft. I recall part of it. I'm like everybody, it was a hodgepodge mess where they were trying to teach you how to obey orders. And so it was a lot of screaming, shouting, and doing push-ups and things like that. Boot camp, again, is just an elongated thing that makes you rely on somebody else to tell you your every move. It got you ready to go into whatever phase the Army wanted to put you in the service. Everybody was scared of everything because we weren't sure what was going to happen. And one nice thing about it, we served with a gentleman who were from all over. We had from the Puerto Ricans and all the states practically in the United States, and we were all shoved together. So none of us knew what was going on, so we became buddies. I received one, and that was, it's called the Army Accommodation Medal. And that was for notorious service over and beyond. All the soldiers were able to send mail home for nothing. We didn't have to put any stamps on it or anything. You just turned them in daily, and the Army brought them home by plane and then took them to the addresses.
Well, thank you for your time today, and thank you for your service.
Originally joined the United States Marine Corps in 1983, straight out of high school. I later joined the United States Navy in 1989, enlisted as a hospital corpsman. My last, or next to last duty station while in the while the Persian Gulf was actively going on was on board the United States, the USS Missouri. We were home ported out of Long Beach, California. I joined to get money for education, gain experience, gain confidence, and above all things, though, to get money for education. Out of the four branches, to me, it felt like the United States Marine Corps and the United States Navy offer more opportunities for travel, better opportunities for advancement, and a broader range of bases to be stationed at, etc. I think it affected my life in a dramatic fashion. Coming straight out of high school, when you feel like you know everything you need to know, it proves to you quickly that you don't. It helps you with discipline, it helps you with goal setting and achieving, teamwork, in general builds your confidence, really helps you mature in a very quick fashion.
Well, thank you, and thank you for your service.
Thank you.
I'm Stephen Ratliff. I served in the armed forces in the Army. I served stateside, and I also served two Asian countries. Actually, when I got my draft notice, I was actually in high school, and I was classified A1. Oh gosh, yeah, I was like all the other young guys there. I remember the first couple of nights, we cried. And then about, I don't know, I guess it was like 2 weeks later, we got to make a phone call home, and you couldn't hold it together. Well, when I first went into the service, you know, I was dedicated in my mind to do the 2 years that I was drafted for, no matter what.
The Tomb of the Unknown Soldier is located upon a hill in Arlington Cemetery and is identified by its white marble neoclassical design and has three figures representing peace, victory, and valor. On the back of the sarcophagus reads, "Here rests in honor and glory an American soldier known but to God." On March 4, 1921, Congress approved the burial of an unidentified soldier from World War I in Arlington Memorial Amphitheater. The journey of the unknown soldier began in France when one of four bodies was selected to be buried in Arlington, while the rest were buried in the Meuse-Argonne American Cemetery. On Armistice Day, Veterans Day today, November 11, 1921, body bearers from the Army, Navy, and Marine Corps transported the casket to a caisson in Arlington, which included over 5,000 people. President Harding then addressed the crowd and placed the Medal of Honor and Distinguished Service Cross on the casket. The ceremony moved to the east of the amphitheater, where a battery cannon fired off three salvos. The casket was lowered into the crypt. A bugler played taps, followed by a 21-gun salute from the battery. Since then, the bodies of three servicemen, one from each war, has been admitted into the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier, one of which has been identified and reinterred to the Jefferson Barracks National Cemetery. The crypt for the Vietnam soldier remains empty, but represents all soldiers from Vietnam who are still registered as MIA. The tomb is protected 24 hours by members of the 3rd U.S. Infantry Unit and has been upholding their sacred duties since 1926. Their shift lasts 30 minutes to 2 hours and live under a strict code of conduct. People often visit the tomb to watch the changing of the guard, which occurs every 30 minutes, but during after hours, it turns to 2 hours between changes.
I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. At the rain, washing up all the pain of yesterday. I know my fears and they've forgiven me. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home.
I'm coming home, I'm coming home.
Oh, tell the world
I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits, and they've forgiven.
Get
falls
down.
Tell the world I'm coming home. I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits. I've forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home.
And where am I praying?
Tell the world.
Set, dude.
Are you happy now?
I'm feeling pretty anxious. I've been waiting for this for quite a long time now. Either she's going to attack me or she's going to freeze.
So what do you think you're going
to
do?
Hopefully not break down.
Attention on deck!
When he first came in through the door, it was a split second of what's going on, and then I realized it was him, and I just took off, even though in fact he wasn't.
Daddy!
over there. We're good.